Hello everyone, today now let us start with Mendeleev's periodic table. So in our last class we studied about Newland's law of octaves and Dobereiner's triad. Today we will see how Mendeleev tried to construct his periodic table. Okay, the first and the main point that you have to remember is that Mendeleev tried to classify elements in the increasing order of their atomic masses and similarities in their properties. Okay, and in the similarities of their properties he considered the formula of the compounds formed by reacting with oxygen and hydrogen. Okay, so most of the elements reacts with oxygen and hydrogen, so he considered those compounds to be one of the basic property in chemical properties. Okay, and in that way he tried to classify the elements in his periodic table. So most of the elements reacts with oxygen and hydrogen and they forms oxides and hydrides of that element. Please all of you take out page number 83, table number 5.4. That is Mendeleev's periodic table, and in that table you can see that group numbers are given in Roman numbers. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So there are 8 groups. Okay, these are called groups. And how many periods are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 periods are there. Am I clear? And under this group it is written oxide and hydride. Okay, so he considered he constructed the table on the basis of this property only. Okay, and formulas are given as R2ORH. Okay, so this type of formulas were formed by the elements on reacting with hydrogen and oxygen. Am I clear? Okay, so Mendeleev's periodic table has 6 horizontal rows called periods and 8 vertical rows called groups. Okay, the groups 1 to 7 had 2 subgroups called A subgroup and B subgroup. Group 8 had 3 rows of elements. Elements having similar properties were placed in the same groups. Are you getting my point? Elements having the similar properties were placed in the same groups. Okay, there are some spaces left vacant in the table to accommodate the elements to be discovered in future. So these are certain characteristics of Mendeleev's periodic table. Now it is having certain merits and demerits also. First merit of the Mendeleev's periodic table is that elements were classified on a more fundamental basis of their atomic mass and properties. Okay, spaces were left vacant to accommodate the elements to be discovered in future. Okay, in the table you can see that in first period and in third and fourth row, scandium, gallium and germanium, 3 elements are there. Okay, if you check it you will find it. 3 elements are there. Those elements were not discovered at that time, but Mendeleev boldly predicted the presence of this element and he said that these elements will be discovered in future and could be accommodated in those empty spaces. Am I clear? So scandium, germanium and gallium, these 3 spaces were left vacant and he could predict the properties of the elements which helped in the discovery of new elements. Okay, and the inert gases, that means noble gases are also called inert gases because they do not react. Their reactivity is extremely low. Under extreme condition only they react, otherwise they doesn't react because they are stable by themselves. So at that time Mendeleev could not discover inert gases, and so later on when inert gases were discovered it could be placed very nicely by making some other extra group. Am I clear? So inert gas elements discovered later could be placed in a separate group without disturbing the table. That means none of the elements, inert elements or noble gases were discovered and it was not placed haphazardly in any position. Okay, later on it was discovered and another group only could be made to fit them in that group. So these were certain advantages of Mendeleev's periodic table, and at that time 63 elements were discovered. Now, certain important defects of Mendeley's periodic table are some elements are not arranged in the increasing order of their atomic masses. Okay, if you check cobalt and nickel or tellurium and iodine, you can see that cobalt is placed before nickel, but nickel is having mass less than that of cobalt. So nickel should be placed at first, then cobalt, because Mendeley only said that that elements are the periodic function of their atomic masses. That means one after another element's atomic masses should increase. Okay, but in this case, cobalt is having mass which is much more greater than that of the mass of nickel. Am I clear? So it was one of the disadvantage. Similarly, you can see for tellurium and iodine also. Okay, and position of hydrogen, it was not clear because it shows properties similar to metals as well as non-metals. Okay, it was not clear about the position of hydrogen. The position of isotopes of elements is also not clear. He did not say anything about isotopes. Okay, so this is the Mendeley's periodic table, and what according to Mendeley's periodic table, the properties of elements are the periodic functions of their atomic masses. That means if you consider hydrogen is having mass less than lithium, so one by one it should increase. Okay, it should increase one after another, and these are the atomic masses written over there. Is it clear? Since there were many disadvantages of Mendeley's periodic table, another scientist called Henry Moseley gave a new property of elements called atomic number. And according to him, properties of elements are a periodic function of their atomic number, not atomic mass. He said that atomic number will be very much helpful if we arrange the elements on the basis of increasing atomic number. It will be very much helpful to construct the table and to arrange the elements in a proper way. Am I clear? And that is called modern periodic table. And in the modern periodic table, it is consist of 18 groups and 7 periods. Okay. And elements present in any one group have the same number of valence electrons. Valence electrons means number of electrons present in the outermost shell. And another thing, elements present in any one period contain the same number of shells, and with increasing atomic number by one unit on moving from left to right, the valence shell electron increases by one unit. And last one, each period marks a new electronic shell getting filled. See, this is the modern periodic table. All of you take out in your book, you will see that there are 7 periods and 18 groups. Okay, it is marked 18 groups. So here you will see that these are the group numbers 1 to 18. Okay, 1 2, so we will deal with group number 1 up to potassium, group number 2 up to calcium, then these middle elements from group number 3 to group number 12, no need to read. These are transition elements having completely different properties, so that is not required for class 10, so we will not read those. This lanthanide and actinide series also not required, so no need to read. This group number 13 to 18 is required. Group number 13 you should remember till gallium. Group number 14 you should remember till germanium. Group number 15 you should remember till arsenic. Group number 16 you should remember till, these two only is enough, oxygen and sulfur. Group number 17, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, these three elements you should know. And group number 18, helium, neon, argon, all of you I think know, but at least you have to remember. Okay, now this is called one group. From top to bottom it is group. Okay, group 1, group 2, then group 13, group 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, these are the periods. In one period how many elements are there? Hydrogen and helium. This is the second period, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. This is the third period, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon. These three periods enough. These three periods you have to remember. Why? Now we will learn four properties. Those four properties you have to read group wise also, and in a period also. So while question comes regarding taking any period, you will take example of second period and third period. Okay, and groups, out of these two groups you can take any groups like group 1 or group 2. Enough. Am I clear? So in our next video we will continue with in detail about modern periodic table. Am I clear? Okay.